Disclaimer: the following analysis is based on preliminary data and limited visual observation, so it may not be 100% accurate. Bear this in mind, please. Having said that, here are all 5GB motherboards from the lowest to the highest tier. The X670 Elite is a 6-layer ATX board with 8+8 12V pins and a power design marketed as twin 16+2+2. This means that the PWM controller, an Infineon XDPE192C3, drives 8 V-core phases with 2 parallel power stages in each one, and possibly also the 2 SoC and 2 miscellaneous phases. Respectively, the power stages are 70A Infineon TDA21472, 60A on Semi NCP303160, and 90A Renesas ISL 99390. All the VRM is cooled by a finless heatsink that rests on thermal pads with a conductivity of 5 or 7 watts per meter Kelvin, but lacks a backplate. Moving on to the expansion slots. Whereas the first PCIe 4x16 is reinforced, the second and the version 3 below it are not, just like the 4 DDR5 slots. It's interesting to note that the last 2 PCIe slots are mechanically x16, yes, but only x4 and x2 electrically. As for storage, somewhere beneath these heatsinks will find one M.2 PCIe 5 socket, 3 version 4, and on the right side, 4 SATA ports. Now the headers. 5 FAN and 5 RGB, 2 of which addressable, 2 USB 2, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1, 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2x2, and then an unusual header for Thunderbolt 4 via head-in card. The Elite also has start, reset, clear CMOS buttons and debug LEDs midboard, but alas, no debug code display. Finally, let's take a look at the back panel. BIOS flashback button, 1 HDMI 2.0, 4 USB 2, 6 USB 3.2 Gen 1, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2, and 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C. The LAN options include wireless 6E plus Bluetooth 5.2 offered by a MediaTek/AMD RZ616 module, and wired 2.5 gigabit per second by Realtek, probably. But no doubt, Realtek provides the ALC897 codec that handles the 3 audio ports. Next comes the X670 Pro. Compared to its little sister, the V-core power stages of this model are now upgraded from 70A to 90A Renesas ISL 99390. The VRM heatsink is definitely equipped with 7 watts per meter Kelvin thermal pads, and the DDR5 slots are reinforced. Not that it matters much. What does matter are 2 more SATA ports and 3 more fan headers. The Pro also trades 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 back ports for Gen 2. The MediaTek Wi-Fi NBT module for Intel AX210 and the unnamed Realtek 2.5G for Intel i225V. Finally, it loses the Lightning connector, but gains an optical SPDIF one. Then, there's the X670E Master, a noteworthy leap, since it's an 8-layer EATX board. Compared to the Pro, here we have a different PWM controller and V-core power stages. Renesas RAE229620 and RAE2201054. Rated for 105A. Besides, the VRM heatsink is now partially finned, has 12 watts per meter Kelvin pads and a backplate. But the main differences certainly involve PCIe. An M.2 PCIe 4 socket and the first PCIe 4 slot are now upgraded to version 5, where the latter is also equipped with an easy release mechanism. a quality of life improvement that, together with the addition of the debug code display, I greatly appreciate. Speaking of its back panel, the Master loses two USB 2 ports, but gains a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C with DisplayPort 1.4 support, and an actual DP 1.4. Finally, the audio codec is the newer Realtek ALC1220, and there are two pump headers as well. Before the flagship, let's talk about the Aero D. This seems to be a hybrid between the Pro and the Master. From the former, it should inherit the same VRM design, its sync qualities, and M.2 sockets, but all other features come from the latter, except for a couple. In this sense, the Aero D loses two USB 2, but then elevates the two Type-C ports to USB 4, with Thunderbolt 3 support too. Lastly, the X670E Xtreme. From a power delivery standpoint, the update over the Master is notable. A Renesas RAE229628 controls 18 real V-Core phases, and probably also the 2 SoC and 2 MIS phases, all cooled by a fully finned heatsink. Moving to the back panel, this board loses all the USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports and the DisplayPort support on its USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C, but in turn gains two extra USB 2 and 3.2 Gen 2 ports. Moreover, the wired LAN is now driven by a 10 gigabit per second Marvel EQC113 controller. There's a clear CMOS button and an external ESS9118 USB DSE. To end, I should point out that all four M.2 sockets are now PCIe 5. Okay, that's good. But what do I think of the Gigabyte lineup? Well, honestly, I don't get the X670 Elite and Pro. Their first expansion slot has been limited to PCIe 4 only, thus their future-proofing is also reduced. In addition, they both lack the debug code display, which I find awfully valuable. This leaves me with the X670E models. The flagship is obviously an excellent board, so it will almost certainly be Xtreme, even in its price. As a consequence, I'm gravitating towards the Master and Aero D. The choice will depend more on the difference in price than on that in features, since it's pretty small. If you prefer to compare these mobos yourself, you will find a spreadsheet in the video description that includes the other vendors as well. Because this is still a work in progress, please let me know if you find any mistakes. Next Monday, I'm gonna show you the MSI lineup, so don't forget to subscribe. Fare you well, for now.